Let's discuss about regression models. In this chapter, we will discuss about what do you mean by regression, where do you apply regression, how to do measuring the fit of the regression model, assumptions of the regression model, then testing the significance. We'll also go into multiple regression analysis, and we will discuss about nonlinear regression as well. What do you mean by regression? Basically, the use of regression is to analyze a relationship between variables, meaning if one variable is depend on the other or not. There are two types of regression. One is called simple linear regression. The other one is called multiple regression. In the case of simple linear regression, we have only two variables. In the case of multiple regression model, we have more than one independent variable. What do you mean by independent variable and a dependent variable? The variable that you want to predict is called dependent variable or response variable. It's on the left-hand side of the equation. The ones on the right-hand side, which are called as independent variables or explanatory variables or predictor variables, these variables combined or these variables have an impact on the dependent variable. So dependent variable depends on the independent variables. Scatter diagram or scatter plot is basically used to represent the relationship between these variables. In the scatter diagram or the scatter plot, the y-axis is used to represent the dependent variable and the x-axis is used to note the independent variable. Let's take an example. A company which is called AAA Construction, they are going to renovate old houses. The sales they make depends on the local payroll of the people. If the people have good salary, then they renovate better. So that means the sales will be high for the company. So if you see the payroll is high, then automatically the sales is also high. So this is just a representation given. If you want to represent the scatter diagram here, the payroll on the x-axis and the sales on the y. Sales is what we are trying to predict, so it's on the y-axis. And payroll on the x-axis. Here you can see we have put the dots and we are trying to fit it by a line, by a straight line. The line is drawn here, but it does not meet all the points you have. Not all the lines, all the points lie on the straight line. This means there is not direct relation, there is no linear exact relationship. So using this notation, using this line, if you try to predict the sales based on a payroll, you might be having a little bit of error. There is a chance of some error. So regression model is used to test the relationship between variables. We represent it using y equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x plus epsilon. Epsilon is the random error which is possible. Y is a dependent variable or the response variable which is on the left hand side. X is an independent variable. Why we call this as a simple linear regression? Because there is only two variables. You have one independent variable and one dependent variable. Beta 0 is called as an intercept. Here, this is the value of y if x is 0. And then you have beta 1, which is the slope of the regression line. So here you can see this is the beta 0. If x is 0, y has some value. Okay. If y doesn't have any value, if y is also equal to 0, then beta 0 will not be there. This is basically a true representation. If you want to find out what is the estimate, estimate is represented using y cap or y caret. Y cap is equal to beta b0 plus b1x. Y cap is the predicted value of y. This is the estimate or the predicted value. B0 is the estimate of beta 0 and b1 is the estimate of beta 1. We don't know the exact value, so we are going to predict. If you make some prediction, there will be some error. So error is equal to the actual value minus the predicted value. If you know the actual value, you can subtract. Let's say you predict for the next year. During the next year, you get the actual value. Subtract the actual value and subtract the predicted value from the actual value. Then you get the error. You can have positive error. You can have negative error. So in our AAA construction, Y is sales, X is area payroll. So we want to make sure the positive error and the negative error does not cancel each other if you do summation. This is the reason we do what is called squaring of the errors. Regression analysis, it minimizes the sum of squared errors. This is called as least squares regression. We want to reduce the error. Whether it is positive or negative doesn't matter. We need to reduce. There are some formula which is available behind the simple linear regression. You can calculate them using this. Y cap equal to B0 plus B1x. X dash, which is the mean of x, is sigma x, which is summation of all the x by n. Similarly, which is number of elements you have. Similarly, y dash equal to sigma y by n. B1, you can calculate summation of x minus x dash into y minus y dash by sigma x minus x dash square. And then B0 is equal to y dash minus b1 x dash. So these are the equations given. So if you are given the values, you can calculate them. Just calculate x minus x dash square and x minus x dash into y minus y dash. Make the summation of them for all the values. Similar for the x minus x dash square also. Some x, some y, divide y dash, x dash, put them in the equation, you get the value. So y cap is equal to 2 plus 1.25x. So this is our calculation. So basically, what do you mean by y cap equal to 2 plus 1.25x? X is the payroll, y is the sales. So if there is an increase of payroll, then it will have 1.25 times increase on the sales. Let's say if there is a 100 million increase in the payroll, that means there will be 125,000 on the sales. Okay, so accordingly we can calculate. Just multiply them. 100 million become 125 million. Next, you need to understand regression model can be developed for x variable, y variable, any variable, even for random numbers. How do you know whether our prediction is useful, it's helpful or not? Errors can be positive, negative. Right, we need to find out. If you do like summation of errors, positive and negative error might cancel out. So to do this, we have three types of variabilities, three measures for to calculate variability. One is called SST, this is variability about the mean. SSE, variability about the regression line. SSR, which is the total variability, which is explained by the model. So you can see SST is summation of y minus y dash square. So this is basically y is the actual value, y dash is the mean value, you are finding the difference between them. Sum of squares error is called SSE, which is y minus y cap. Y is actual, y cap is the predicted value. Sum of squares regression, this is y cap minus y dash square summation. Okay, this is between y cap, which is the predicted, minus y dash is the mean value. Basically, SST is equal to, so if you subtract between y and y dash, it is equal to y to y cap and then y cap to y dash. So it is SSR plus SSE. Again, you can calculate for the given model. You just calculate all the values. You get what is SSE, SSR, SST. So SST is between y and y dash. SSE is between y and y cap. SSR is between y cap and y dash. So here are the values given, calculated and given for you for the AAA construction. So if you want to represent our scatter diagram, you want to represent them. So here, this is my y dash line. This is the mean value of y. And this is my prediction, y cap equal to 2 plus 1.25x. And if you see here, this is actual value of y. But the predicted value of y for this is somewhere here, okay, on the line. Okay. So this is y minus y cap, which is the predicted line. And if you want to find the difference between the y cap and the y dash, so this is this, y cap and the y dash. This is y cap minus y dash, this part here. And then the total difference between y and y dash is from y here to y dash here, which is y minus y dash. So you can see y minus y dash is equal to y minus y cap plus y cap minus y dash. SSR is called explained variability in y, while SSE is called unexplained variability. What is SSR? What is SSE? Just remind you, SSE is between y and y predicted. SSR is between y predicted and y mean, which is the mean y. Okay. So you can see SSR and SSE are given to you. So if you want to find the coefficient of variability or coefficient of determination, which is called R square, how far they are, right, this is using SSR by SST, okay, using the explained variability divided by SST here. So for the R-square construction, the values are given here. So just use the value of SSR, which is basically between y cap and y dash, and divide it by the SST, which is total. You get 0.69. This means we have a variability of 69%, which could be explained by the equation. What does this mean by? Let's say, if y and y cap become the same, what we predict and the actual value is the same. What will happen if what we predict and what is the actual value become the same? Then SSE will be zero. Because Y is the actual value, Y cap is the predicted value. If both are the same values, then you get zero. SSE is zero. If SSE is zero, right, then you can see 1 minus SSE by SST is the R square, coefficient of determination. So SSE is zero, then R square will become 1. What do you mean by R square is 1? 100% variability is explained by the regression equation. Meaning everything is matching. That is 100%. Now 69% is matching according to this calculation here. Okay. Y cap matching with Y is 69% right now. So if you want to find what is called correlation coefficient. So this is called as R square is called coefficient of determination. If you want to find correlation coefficient, which is called R, this is something between plus and minus. So this is between plus 1 to minus 1. It will tell you whether it's a negative relationship or a positive relationship. So you just have to get the square root of R square. Okay, you get the value. And you have to put the plus and minus based on the slope. If the slope is positive, put plus. If the slope is negative, put minus. That's it. So slope you can get from the B1 value. Look at the sign of it, whether it's positive or negative. So R equal to square root of R square, you get the value. And look at the B1. B1 is plus 1.25. So this means a positive correlation coefficient. You can have correlation is equal to 1 if it is a perfect match. It can be between 0 and 1, but positive correlation. Okay. It can be no correlation, totally outside the line. And R equal to minus 1 if it is a negative correlation. There are certain assumptions we need to make in case of the regression model. The assumptions are this. Based on the errors. The errors will be independent, errors are normally distributed, errors have a mean of zero, errors have constant variation regardless of the value of x. If x changes, doesn't matter, the variance should be constant. Okay. So we can see whether a given scenario violates these assumptions or not. These are assumptions. Here is a situation. You are given x, you are given the error. Okay. So here you can see the error is distributed and it is independent of the independent variable is random. So this is meeting all the assumptions. There is no problem. So you can apply your regression model to this scenario. Let's take the next one. Here, as x increases, the error increases. So that means it violates what is called constant variance. We said irrespective of the value of x, error should be constant in their variances. Here it is not. So it violates. If you look at this one, error is increasing first, then decreasing. It's following a non-linear pattern, maybe a quadratic, maybe some other pattern. So this will also create violations to our assumptions. So if you want to find errors mean squared error, if you want to find MSE, which is S square, if you want to calculate it, it's done using MSE equal to SSE, which is a sum squared error, by N minus K minus 1. What do you mean by N minus K minus 1? N, how many observations you make. K, number of independent variables. Okay, so this is the issue. Another problem is errors are assumed to have a constant variance and you don't know them. So if you want to find something equivalent of sigma square, then you find S square, which is the mean squared error, which is calculated using SSE by N minus K minus 1. So for our AAA construction, you know the SSE value. Just divide it. Number of observations we got is 6. So if you look at the table of AAA construction, the values they are given. Here, there are only 6 values. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is 6 and N is 6. So next, you have to find what is K. K is the number of independent variables. There's only one independent variable. So it is 1 and minus 1, you get the value. So if you want to get what is called a standard deviation, which is S, which is equal to square root of MSE. Standard error of the estimate, or it's also called the standard deviation of the regression. These are just names given to you. There is some issue here. Whether the model is proper or not. Is it significant or not? The problem is this. Sometimes we can have a very small sample. From that, if you calculate everything, you get a very good MSE. We also get a good R square. But maybe there is no relationship at all. So we need to test the significance to make sure whether it is right, whether the values you got is correct or not. This is done using what is called statistical hypothesis test. This is the procedure to do it. We have the general linear model, y equal to beta square plus beta 1x plus epsilon.
beta 1 equal to 0. If beta 1 is equal to 0, that means there is no relation between x and y. Right? If there is no slope, then there is no relation. So this is called null hypothesis. If there is a linear relationship, or if there is any other relationship, then beta 1 should not be equal to 0. So meaning, we need to prove that the null hypothesis can be rejected. Then only we can say there is a relationship. We use what is called F statistic. How to use F statistic? F statistic is basically based on MSR and MSE. We know what is MSE. How to calculate MSR now? Okay, MSR we know. MSE we know. MSE is by SSE by N minus K minus 1. We need to know what is MSR. MSR is SSR by K. K is the number of independent variables. F statistic is calculated using this procedure. F equal to MSR by MSE. And there is also a table by which we get the F value. Okay, there are two values of F. One is what you calculate, one what you obtain from the table. From the table, it is represented using what is called F distribution. There are two notations there. One is called DF1 and DF2. DF1 is the degree of freedom for the numerator, which is equal to K. DF1 is equal to K. Degree of freedom for the denominator is DF2 equal to N minus K minus 1. Okay? N minus K minus 1. If the error is very little, okay, very little error, then MSE will be small, then F statistic will be large. If MSE is small, F statistic will become large. Okay, because MSE is the denominator for F statistic. So MSE is small, F statistic will become large. Then we will say the model is useful. If F statistic is large, then the significance value, which is called a significance level, which is called P value, will be low. And this means, if this happens, that means there is no way that things have happened by a chance, by a random chance, something like this. So there is a real relationship. When F value is large, we can simply reject the null hypothesis, meaning beta 1 is not equal to 0, and accept that there is some relation between them, and we have the values of MSE and R square, what you have calculated is meaningful. So this is the step, these are the steps you got to follow if you want to do the hypothesis test. First you have to say H0, which is hypothesis 0, beta 1 equal to 0. This is called null hypothesis. H1, we are rejecting the null hypothesis, beta 1 not equal to 0. You should be given what is called as level of significance. This should be given. Commonly, they will use 0.01 and 0.05. Then we calculate what is called F calculated, MSR by MSE. Then you make a decision using any one of these rules. One of them is called reject the null hypothesis. If the test statistic is greater than the F value from the table. What do you mean by test statistic? Test statistic is the F calculated, which you have calculated using MSR by MSE. If that is greater than what you get from the table, of table is F of alpha comma beta DF1 comma DF2, where DF1 is equal to K, degree of freedom of the numerator, and of the denominator is N minus K minus 1, if it is greater, if F calculated is greater, you reject the null hypothesis, meaning there is a relationship. Second option, reject the null hypothesis if the observed significance level, which is a P value, is less than the level of significance, which is alpha. Okay. How to calculate the P value? That's again, a methodology is available. So let's do the calculations now for the given example. H0, beta 1 is equal to 0, meaning there is no relationship. H1, beta 1 not equal to 0, meaning there is some linear relationship that exists. You are taking alpha, which is the level of significance is 0.05. We know what is MSR. MSR is SSR by K. We know the SSR. K is 1. K is the independent variable. You have only one independent variable. You get the value here. F equal to MSR by MSE. Just divide them. You get the value. This is called F calculated. Now we have to get DF1, K equal to 1. Okay. DF2 N minus K minus 1, which is 6 minus 1 minus 1, which is 4. You are given alpha equal to 0.05, which means 5% level of significance. Here is the table given. So DF2, we have value as 4. DF1 from this here, DF1 is 1, so you get 7.71. So F of 0.05 comma 1 comma 4, 1 is a DF1, 4 is a DF2, F of 0.05 is the alpha, equal to 7.71 from the table. What you have calculated is 9.09 from the previous slide. So now you can reject H0. Why? Because F calculated is greater than 7.71. So we can conclude there is a relationship between X and Y. What is the variability from them, from the equations we are given? We know what is R square value, which is 16.69. Means 69% is explained by our predicted equations like. And there are some models which can calculate what is called ANOVA table. ANOVA stands for analysis of variance. This is a model which you can use some software to do it. And here we can get what is called the p-value, observed significance level or level of significance. It's calculated for the f-value. So this is the table which you will find based on the calculations. You get regression, k, and you get residual n minus k minus 1, SSR, SSE, SST, and then MSR is SSR by k, MSE is SSE by n minus k minus 1. You get f, which is the MSR by MSE. Then we get the significance, p, which is probability of f greater than MSR by MSE. You get this value, right? Here is a calculation given to you from an Excel output. Here you see the value is 0.034. Actual alpha value is 0.05, okay? Because this is less than, this value is less than 0.05, you reject the null hypothesis, right? And you say there is a linear relationship between X and Y. You can solve this using many software examples. So let's continue. Next, if you're going to talk about multiple regression. Multiple regression is an extension to the simple regression, linear regression. Here you have more than one independent variable. That's a big difference. Y stands for the dependent variable. Xi, X1, X2, X3, which is various independent variables. Beta 0 is the intercept where all the Xi's are 0. What is the value of Y? And beta I is coefficient of each independent variable. And K is the number of independent variable. And epsilon is the random error. If you want to get the estimate, again, y cap or y caret is equal to beta b0 plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2 until bk xk. This is clear. Beta b0 is a sample intercept. Bi is a sample coefficient of each variable. And y caret is actually a y cap, is the predicted value of y. Here, they are taking an example of a company which is going to sell houses. The house's price is based on the size and the age of the house. So y cap is a predicted value, which is a selling price. Y intercept is B0, X1 and X2, X1 for the square size of the house, X2 is the age of the house, B1, B2 are the slopes respectively. And here is a sample record given to you, selling price, square, age, there is something called condition. You will see how to represent condition inside our data. All right, here they have calculated using some software like Excel and they have given you the equations. Simple here. Similar to simple linear form regression model, we can evaluate things also here. We can use the p-value for the f-test and r-square like before. There is small difference in terms of hypothesis. Previously, we had only one independent variable. Now we have more than one independent variable. Okay? So if in the f-test, we need to check whether all the coefficients are zero at the same time. So here, we will do like this. We have to do calculation like this. Evaluation is done like this. H0, beta 1 equal to 0. We are doing for each one separately. Beta 1 equal to 0. H1, beta 1 not equal to 0. Right? And test statistics is calculated if p value is less than, lower than the level of significance alpha, which you already seen. Same procedure. Null hypothesis is rejected. So you have to do for each one, beta 1, beta 2, like this. So here is the scenario. P value of F test is given to you. R square is also given. So we calculate alpha equal to 0, what is the p-value? P-value, you get this value. This is less than the value of alpha, which is 0.02, 0.002. So we will say null hypothesis 0.05, sorry, 0.05 here, alpha is 0.05. So we reject the hypothesis, null hypothesis. And then for the next x2, basically the age, so we have to calculate, which is x1 is the square footage, which is the size of the house. X2 is the second independent variable, which is the age. It should be X2 here. Alpha equal to 0.05. P-value is also given, 0.0039. Here again, p-value is less than 0.05. So null hypothesis is rejected. So we mean there is some relationship. Simply, we can say there is a relationship. And both of them, the square, the size of the house and the age of the house is useful or helpful in predicting the selling price. We have what is called dummy or binary or indicator variable. These are things which are like special variables created for qualitative data. Basically, we assign the value like it's a binary. So we assign 1 or 0. If the condition is met, we put 1. Condition is not met, we put 0. You can add some number of dummy variables. But the number of dummy variables we add is equal to 1 less than the number of categories you have. In our example, if you go back to the example given to you, the condition we have good, excellent, mint. There are 3 conditions possible. So how many variables, dummy variable you should add? You should add only 2. Okay, because it says here number of dummy variable is 1 less than. Okay, number of categories is 3, so 1 less than. So then how do you represent the third category? Let's see. We have x3. x3 equal to 1 mean the house is in excellent condition. If it is 0, that means it's not in excellent condition. That's it. x4 is equal to 1. Why x3? Because x1 is used for the size of the house. x2 is used for the age of the house. These are the independent variables. x4 equal to 1, it means the house is in a mint condition. If x4 is 0, it's not in a mint condition. If x3 and x4 both are 0, it means the house is in a good condition. That is the third category. That's it. So to have 3 categories, you need 2 dummy variables. So you can add them, you can solve them using some tool, and you can get the answers like. Here again, the coefficient of determination is also given, which is 0.0898 from the calculations here. Well, there's few important points here. See, a model is statistically significant if you have higher R square value. If you keep on adding variables to the model, you have 2 independent variables, now you make it 3, R square will increase. But this doesn't mean the system is statistically significant. Okay, statistically significant. So what you have to do is, you have to calculate what is called adjusted R square. Adjusted R square is needed so that it doesn't mean if you keep adding variables, R square will increase. No, R square will increase, but adjusted R square will not increase just because you are adding variables. It adjusted R square takes into account the number of independent variables. So you can see the difference between R square and adjusted R square is given here. R square is SSR by SST, which is equal to 1 minus SSE by SST. Adjusted R square is equal to 1 minus SSE by N minus K minus 1. N number of samples minus K is the number of independent variable minus 1. SST is SST by N minus 1. This is adjusted R square. So if you are increasing the number of variables, this is going to be in the denominator. Okay, if you're increasing things like the value in the denominator is going to impact, is going to go down. That means SST will go up. That means this number 1 minus will go down. Okay, if you increase, it's going to go down. But if the increase provided by the new variable, okay, causes SSC to decrease, then basically what will happen? The R square, adjusted R square will increase. So the difference between R square and adjusted R square is this. In the case of R square, addition of any variable, any independent variable, is going to increase the value of R square. But in the cases of adjusted R square, it is not always the case the adjusted R square will increase. It might decrease, it might increase based on the significance of the variable. Okay, so if adjusted R square is increasing, that means the variable you have added new should be included in the model. Probably it is very important to be included. In the case of model building, we have some procedure. One is called stepwise regression. Here what we do is this, we have forward stepwise, backward stepwise. We put one significant variable first, the most significant, then we add the next one, see whether the model improves or not. In the case of backward stepwise, we put all the independent variables. Then we delete the least helpful, go down the list. And here you need to understand, in some variables, variables can contain duplicate information. For example, if 2 independent variables are correlated, that's called collinear. If you have more than 2 independent variables which are correlated, it's called multicollinearity. If there is a multicollinearity, hypothesis, if you are doing for a separate coefficient, they are not valid. Maybe the model is still useful. Okay, it will say, hypothesis say they are not valid, but the model is useful. These are conflicts you can have. Similar, if multicollinearity exists, overall F test is still valid, but the hypothesis test on individual ones, if you test for each and individual variable, that might not be true. Okay, that is not valid. Maybe because it's collinear, it depends on one with the other. A variable might appear to be significant while it is not, and the otherwise is also true. In some cases, the variables are not linear, they are non-linear regressions. Then in that scenario, maybe we want to convert the non-linear into linear model. Here is a scenario of a company which want to study the impact of weight on the millions miles per gallon. Okay, miles per gallon is given as mpg, and the weight of the vehicle is given to you. Here if you represent by a straight line, you see there is a lot of error, things are outside the list. So here we can see small test for significance. You can find good R square value, you can calculate them. You can also find out that this is a non-linear mapping. The curve matches nicely. So you can say it's a quadratic model. Here you can say B0 plus B1 into weight plus B2 into weight square. Weight square makes it non-linear. If you want to keep an equivalent of this in the linear model, you can represent weight square as X2. And you can represent like this, B0, B1, X1 plus B2, X2. But here remember, X1 and X2 are not really independent variables. You cannot put one as constant, the other is changing. No, it's not possible. X2 is dependent on X1. So if X1 increases, X2 will also increase by the square. X2 equal to X1 square. So this is the point here. So here also, this is a better model. Here the values can be calculated. Small f test is found here, and adjusted values are also increased accordingly. There are some issues here. If the assumptions are not met, like the errors given, error assumptions, they are not met, statistical test may not be valid. Correlation does not mean causation. What do you mean by causation? Two independent variables might individually change due to different reasons. Maybe they are changing due to some other reason. Doesn't mean one change is affecting the other. Causation means if I change one variable, it will affect the other variable to change. This is called causation. Correlation, if one is changing, the other is also changing. Maybe the reason is due to some other case that both are changing, but they are not causing one another to change. Multicollinearity makes our planning difficult. Okay, our model may be good, but if you go and look for each and every individual coefficient, then they might not be right. It's questionable because of multicollinearity. Right, and then you have only got values for a range. Your sample data is for a range. Outside the range, you don't know how the regression is going to be, how the relation is going to be. So if the value is within the range, it will work through. If it is outside the range, it will not work through. It might not work through. And you can do what is called as a t-test for the intercept B0. Right, maybe because it is outside, okay, t-test might be outside the range of the model. It is possible. Right, sometimes linear might not be the best relation. Even though your f-test gives you a good value, linear might not be. Maybe there is a non-linear existing, right? Or maybe there is non-linear exist while there is linear does not exist. These are all possibilities. So even though there is a relationship, even though a relationship is statistically significant, it may not have any practical value. The impact might be just due to a small sample. We have taken a very small sample, so it doesn't have real impact. Because of the small sample, we are saying there is significance, but in reality, may not be there. This ends this chapter.